There's a lot of women out there that's really strong-headed because feminism has actually been moving throughout the earth. They're actually misled by this agenda that's actually pushed by the spirit of Cain. See, there's two patriarchs that the Most High dealt with in the scriptures. The first patriarch was a righteous. There's a deluge of women out there. A deluge of women out there are going to be astonished by what's about to come. You're never going to be prepared for what's about to take place through the spirit of the Ruach HaKadosh, the spirit of Adonai. It's putting in this earth. So there's a lot of women out there that's actually misled, misguided by feminism, and they have been operating under the presumption that they really believe that that's the answer. It's the same spirit that distracted Eve in the garden when she yielded to Satan and went against the Most High and her husband. That spirit is still in the earth. A lot of women out there, deluge of women out there, being deceived by that spirit of Cain that's moving throughout this earth. You're under the deception of feminism, which is actually a spirit of Cain. Allow me to explain. See, when the Most High created man, he created a patriarch. He created man, and then he later created woman from the man, which is why we refer to you as the rib, because you came from a man's rib. And so he created you for the man. You can read that in the scriptures, right? Genesis 2 and 18. You are a helpmeet. It's not about your mission. And I know this is going to sound incredibly misogynistic, right? And biased, but it's according to the Most High. Now, if you refer to yourselves as Christians or true believers, then you will have a problem with this. You will have a problem with your thought process, which is in direct contrast to the Most High. So he created woman as a helpmeet for the man. Now, he created a righteous patriarch, but there became an evil patriarch in the earth. And that was the spirit of Cain. See, Abel was a righteous patriarch, right? He created Adam to be a patriarch because he created Adam and told Adam, hey, you rule in my stead and you name everything on this earth. And I'm going to give you a woman just for a form of support. She's going to be a helpmeet, but you're the ruler. And then Adonai Elohim said, it is not good for man to be alone. I will create a helpmeet for him. And you're responsible for making this woman to remain in order and everything else under you. It's under your dominion besides me, the Most High. Adam was a simp and he failed at that. The woman yielded to Satan because he did not continue to have that woman under his covering and protection and instructions. So comes along Cain and Abel. After Adam and Eve is kicked out of the garden. And so Cain did not offer life. Abel did. Abel offered the blood of a life. So the Most High accepted his offering. Right? Which is why we previously used to go to the altar and offer a blood sacrifice. Cain offered something that didn't have a life. And so the Most High rejected his offering. And he killed his brother Abel. That's the spirit. That's the spirit that's moving in the earth today. And that's the spirit that's misleading Eve. The spirit of being nude, semi-nude, is a spirit of Cain, an unclean spirit. So there's a righteous patriarch, which are from righteous men. And there's a wicked, evil patriarch, a Cain. And that's the patriarch support system that's misleading, misdirecting women. Let us not forget that your foremother Eve had an unclean spirit. She went against the Most High and her husband and made a covenant with Satan. You do not have that righteous spirit of Sarah. The scriptures tells you to be daughters of Sarah, but you have that unclean spirit of Eve, the spirit of Cain. Understand that. And so because of the spirit of Cain, the spirit of Cain has allowed women to go into family court systems and divorce rape men, deprive men of their seed, of their children, and just be able to fabricate stories against men, even if it's not true, to destroy that righteous male patriarch.
I've been calling this girl all morning, bro. The paper just came in. I've been calling her all morning, dummy. Find out the baby not mine. What am I? Like, bro. This girl been playing in my face all morning, bro. All morning. You come drop that baby off with nothing. And it's just gonna ring out.
Please
Been calling her all morning, man. All morning, bro. I do everything for both of them, bro. Her and her mother. I take care of these girls, bro. I just got a new house, bro. I just moved. I uprooted my entire life for this.
She been wanting your ass about this shit.
To find out. To find out the baby not mine, bro.
Okay, but. These are simply the times of Jacob's trouble, but we shall survive it. But the woman is out of control because she's being misguided by this wicked spirit of Cain. When Eve ate from that tree, that was direct rebellion against the Most High and her husband. And that spirit is continuously in the earth. And that spirit was born again through the spirit of Cain, which is a spirit of a wicked male patriarch versus the righteous one that the Most High created. And so thus, Sirach 25 and 19 says, all wickedness is but little to the wickedness of a woman.
I have clients who regret divorcing their husbands because they later realized that what they were asking for or what they were feeling in the moment was just that, a feeling in the moment. Many women have good ones, but what I consider to be a good one may not be what you consider to be a good one. Some women think that a man who he does everything the same every day, you know exactly where he is. He's literally has the same schedule every day. They think that is boring. They think it is mundane and they want something else. They want fire and spice and spontaneity and they want all the things. And there's nothing wrong with that. But women divorce men for that.
Okay, so there is something wrong with that. And what's wrong with it is it's fictitious. It's a fairy book. It's unrealistic. And, you know, even this woman right here, though she, you know, seemed like to some that's naive enough to believe that she's in favor of, you know, men, you know, she has a draw up that she's performing, and you know the way that her cleavage is exposed, and how she said that there's nothing wrong with that. It shows you that she's not coming from a righteous spirit herself. And this is why I warn you, Akim, about women out here that's trying to counsel men on the type of women they should select. Don't take counsel from women on the type of woman you should be with. You got to get your counsel from a righteous man of the Most High. Hallelujah. Yeah.
It doesn't mean he wasn't a good one at all. It means he wasn't a good one for her at the time. Because if that wasn't the case, even Tyrese's ex-wife, Tyrese the singer, would not have admitted to regretting divorcing him. Because he was what? A good one. Come on. This is
for this life. You keep talking about what you want. What the fuck you gonna do for somebody? When I sit on my knees and I get up every morning and I pray to God and I tell him, yo, what is it that you need me to do? I get up, I show myself to be appreciative and thankful, and then I ask him, what is it that you want me to do? You so busy saying, what can I have? God, send me this. Send me this man. And then you, when you get with the man, you keep talking about what he ain't doing and what he gonna do for you. What you gonna do for him? Come to the table, come to the altar, and help me to understand what you gonna do for me. Why should I even consider you? Why should I qualify you as a part of even being in my sphere? Why should I even look your way? Because that's a good dude. And his earning potential ain't until his late 50s and early 60s. His trajectory is up. When you continue to decline, and you hitting the wall, and you continuing to go down, and your trajectory is down, a down slope, What value do you continue to add? Why should he then continue to take care of you if you're unwilling to make the sacrifice to see it through? You want everything now.
It's true, baby. He is not your husband.
Please.
And you are not going to sit here on this room with me and cry over somebody that does not deserve your tears. Absolutely not.
Are you saying you don't want me?
And this is precisely where the prophecy of Adonai Elohim is saying, rise up, ye women that are at ease. Hear my voice, you careless daughters. Give ear unto my speech. Because the women, they're saying, hey, we're in power now. We're in rulership. But it's the spirit of Cain and Eve. So this is why the prophecy says there shall be a confusion in many places. And the fire should be often break out. And wild beasts shall roam beyond their haunts, and menstruous women, meaning unclean women, shall bring forth monsters. That means their children, their seeds are going to be wild like monsters.
Hey, peace. What's up? All right. I divorced my husband. Why did I divorce my husband? I divorced my husband because I was making a certain amount of money. I divorced my husband because I thought I didn't need him anymore. I divorced my husband because I had this senior position at work and thought I held the same position at home. I divorced my husband because I thought I was better than him because I had my degree now. I divorced my husband because I thought a successful marriage meant I was here and he was down here. That is not success. That's fucking sickness. I found myself divorced and out there looking for love in all the wrong places. Fucking this one and that one and that one and that one and this one and that one. And my body count going up and my value going down. I'm just gonna call it like a T.I. is. All the while, my husband done found somebody else building a relationship and building a life with them. I should have stayed married.
So everything that she named was personally for her, not for her created purpose. Remember, in Genesis 2 and 18, Bereshit 2 and 18, the woman was created for the man to be a helpmeet. Right? But this woman was naming off everything for herself, which goes against the Most High. So Sirach 36 and 24 says that he that getteth a wife, he getteth a possession, a hope like unto himself. Ephesians 5 and 22 through 24, it's telling a woman to be submissive to her husband as unto Adonai, that you call the Lord. And not in some things, but in all things. Obey him in all things. In Bereshit, Genesis 3 and 16, it says, your desire shall be unto your husband, and he shall rule over you. That's the order that the Most High set up in this earth. And don't say it's after the curse, because prior to the curse, you can see the woman was actually created for a helpmeet for the man. The Most High gave Adam dominion over all. The Most High dealt with patriarchs. The patriarchs are Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And they're considered to be significant figures in the Bible. Right? And these patriarchs are important because Adonai Elohim spoke directly to them and used them to begin his lineage that led to the nation of Israel, Yasha Allah.
Sirach chapter 25, verse 19. All wickedness is but little to the wickedness of a woman. Let the portion of a sinner fall upon her. I want to give all praises to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahabashai, Bahashem, Rakah, Kodash.
Ms. Turner is your biological daughter?
No.
If you do find out today, are you willing to allow him to be in your life?
37 years, you could possibly move forward.
Telling me how you wanted to have a relationship and how, and everything was going great. Say, I got new information.
Because right, I don't want to face failure from you again.
Ms. Turner, you've been hurt a lot, and we have to take it one step at a time. And I will say this, if you weren't worth it to him, he would not have called this court.
It's time for the results.
Miles versus Turner. Christine Turner. Mr. Miles, you are not the father.